Hey everyone. So in this video, I'm going to go through how to update all the details here from moving all the data under this old property we've got here for country region, which is a text-based property, and moving that over into this new property for just called country, which is a drop-down property. And this video is related to a couple of other videos that I've done about this country default country property in HubSpot and how many people want to actually make this a drop down instead of text-based. So check out that video that I've already published before. And in that video, I go through a method of updating this property using bulk edits, basically where you go through like this and you select which ones you want to make Australia and you change each one like this. So, but that only really works when you've got like, say, five options here. There's just five countries. If there were like 100 different countries or 50 different countries, that would just be too time consuming to make that change. The other way I went through as well is with the workflows and how to set up a workflow to do it like this. And you can check out the video that I've done about that one. But again, this really only works when you've got, say, five countries you're concerned with. And because you need to go through and sort of update. When you do a dropdown, when you're updating a dropdown, you need to update each one. You need to tell HubSpot or your database which one you should be selecting because the text and the dropdown are not connected. You know, for a human, it's quite easy to see that Australia equals Australia. But for a system, it doesn't really know because this dropdown is actually just data. It doesn't know that this particular text here is corresponding to this particular dropdown. So you need to do it another way. So the other option is to use an export and then an import. So we basically take all the data that we've got in this column here, and we're going to paste it using a spreadsheet. We're just going to paste it in this option here and then re-import it. So let me show you how to do that. So the first step is we've got to export the data. So we've got our view here, which we've set up previously. And as you know, with some of my other videos, I've gone through views, creating views and the difference between views and lists. And you can see here, we've got all of our different views. This is one I created in that previous video that I made. And we've got all of our properties columns, the way we want them to be shown. Some of these we won't need. We really only need the email and the two country columns, but I'll leave them here just to make it easy to export this particular view. And so once we've got the contacts we want, we've got 147 records, we've got our columns in place. Now we can click export and we're going to send ourselves this spreadsheet. So when you export, it's always good to double check you're exporting the right view, the number of rows that you want to export. You can choose different formats depending on your preference. It doesn't matter too much. And you can see, you know, in your process, I often choose CSV, but I'm going to choose Excel for this one. And we're going to actually edit it in Google Sheets anyway, so it doesn't matter too much. You want to include just the properties in your view. Otherwise, if you include all properties, you'll end up with maybe a 200 different columns and it's probably unnecessary. You can also include all email addresses if you've got multiple email addresses, but I don't want to do that because I'm going to be using the email as the unique identifier for each contact, each record. So we won't need to do that. So you can leave all this the same. We'll click export. And then basically while it's exporting, it'll let you know when it's ready, but it's usually pretty fast with a small list like this. We've got our key targets, so we can download that sheet. I'm gonna import it into Google Drive so I can edit it quickly. I like to use Google Drive instead of Excel because for this kind of thing, it can be much faster. You can obviously collaborate easier and you can also export as a CSV super easy. So we open this and while this is opening, we're basically going to go through, I'm just going to copy this sheet straight away just so that I have a reference. And I usually change the name of this one to import. And then I'm just going to remove all the columns I don't really need just in case they get mixed up. So we'll delete those. And I end up with this old country region and the new country property. And then I'm going to simply take all of these and just paste them in this column. So we're going to just drag down, very, very easy, too easy, and then paste. So now we've got our drop down Now, the important thing to note is that in the properties for this value, you need to make sure they already exist in that dropdown. So let's have a look at country that we've recently created. And we can see here, well, there's a lot of countries here, but we can see here that all the countries are here. It needs to be spelt exactly the same. So if, for example, we were looking at United States, and a common problem might be that it says United States, but in your sheet, maybe yours says, let's say USA or something like that. You know, if you copy USA over to this one here, it's not going to import properly, because the import's going to be looking for this particular text, specifically this here. So you've got to make sure you have that exact text there. Or if you do want to use USA, you either change this or you add another option which has USA instead. So we won't change that. Oops, we'll just copy this here, paste that there. Okay, and then when you're ready, actually we don't even need these values either, so we'll just delete them for sake of simplicity. Now we have everything we need. These ones are already blank, so I'll just leave them. Unless you wanted to update them, maybe I'll change them to Australia as well. And then we can just say download as CSV, like that. I like CSV because CSV will pull only the active sheet that we're looking at, and it won't pull the whole spreadsheet, you know, with the two sheets, because that'll cause issues when we import. So we want to say download as CSV. We get our little download down here, and then we come back here and we're going to go to import. And we select start and import, import file from computer. We're going to choose just one file, one object, because we're talking just about the contacts object. We're not doing company imports or deals or anything else. We're just doing contacts. So we click one object there. We select that object, which is the contacts. And we drag the file into this box. We can choose to import and up. Just update or just create new, but in this case we're going to do both, create and update contacts. It doesn't really matter because we don't have any new contacts, so it's not going to actually create any new contacts. That's an option there. Click next, and then we just double check everything corresponds. So actually we don't even need this one, because this data we're not using this, we just use this as a reference to copy paste. So we can not import this column and change that to don't import, and we just double check that this one from the spreadsheet with the email column is corresponding to the right HubSpot property. We can see here that it's not corresponding to the right one here. It's the old one. And we want to select that new one because they have the same, very similar names. Here's the new one. So that's good that we caught that one. And so country is going to correspond to country, and then it's going to update. Let's see if this works. Click next. We have the name of the import. I usually keep this the same, even though it's long and a bit ugly, so that I can find the Google sheet later on, find what I've where this import came from, you know, if there's an error or something I need to troubleshoot. And then we can say that these are already contacts we had in our database. So they do have, they all have agreed already. There's been already a process for these contacts. I usually don't tick anything else at this stage. You can always do it later as well. And we click finish import, and then that will import. And so this is probably, I'd say this is the fastest way to update contacts like this, to update the properties. But it's a little bit risky as well, because if you do the wrong thing, it can potentially send the data to the wrong property, and it can be hard to fix that, troubleshoot that later. One other great thing in HubSpot, which they've recently added to certain levels subscription, I believe, is the ability to clean up your imported data. So you can actually click here and you can see any details that are missing. In this case, the names are fine, but then the surname is suspicious. So we've got here that HubSpot's looked at this, it sees current is just called G. Maybe you just want to remove it because it's not really adding any value. Maybe in this case, the last name says test, and also the same sort of thing. Maybe you want to remove that as well. In this case, I'm going to keep all this because it's just a demo account, but it can be good to look at these formatting issues and maybe just make some quick, you know, accept the changes very quickly, because it can be a nice way to keep your database more clean. So we've got 147. Let's go back to our view and we'll have a look. And yeah, we can see here, you know, these three that were blank, they've been updated to Australia. All the other ones have been successfully updated. So that's worked. So let me know what you think, if that's been useful for you. And And also feel free to share any other ideas, any other questions, anything else you'd like to sort of go through if in a future video. And I'd love to hear your feedback and any questions and everything as well. So thanks again for watching. Really appreciate it. And look forward to seeing you in the next video. Cheers.